Hey Lego fans, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a Lego Legends of Chima set review. This is set number 70112. It's the 15th Speedorz set in the official accounting of it. This one features Croc, and this is called the Croc Chomp. So let's get to chomping at the build, because I'm chomping at the bit. And I just want to see this thing done, so I'm going to bring in the magic finger of building. Ha! Yes! All right, let's do this. Let me get some of the simple things out of the way. First off, the cards. There they are. Check them out. Hit the pause button if you want to see them in more detail. I'm not going to go through explaining what you can see here very clearly. Pretty cool to look at. Chi crystals, six of them free, plus one built in here, but these are the ones that you play with. Ripcord, green for the Croc tribe. All right, and let's look at the weapons. This is a Jabba, a spear basically, and this is a Ripperess. This is a very cool double-bladed Croc specific weapon. Chi infused, obviously. Definitely looks like something that'd be very powerful, kind of the almost the Chima. I'll say it's the Croc equivalent of a double-sided or double-bladed lightsaber. Yeah, this is good stuff. Croc is actually not new to this set. We've had him before, but here's a look at him anyway. Take a look at the print there. It's a pretty good print. They do a good job with the torso and leg prints with most of these Chima characters. You can see a little bit of integration between the print on the torso and on the hips. He's got his steel lower jaw, a little scale detail around the side of the head, and a print on the back of the torso. Here's what the face looks like underneath on one side, and then turning that around on the other side, a little more surprised or maybe even scared, like, I'm not gonna hit the obstacle right, I'm gonna crash. Here is Croc's Speedorz. It's a Chompor V9, and the power-up back here is called a Fangorur, and it really chops through and cuts through foliage to help you get through tough stuff and to really create a path behind you for further warriors to follow up. But, you know, I should go through this and be objective about it, but, you know, forget that. This is my favorite Speedorz to date, period, hands down. I like this thing a lot. I like the color, I love the color. It's transparent, bright green, one of my favorite colors in the Lego palette, period. But then they also give it a good print, a very good print. Gives good coverage, works well with the teeth down there on the bottom, which are not printed. You've got this area here, you've got a little chomp bite mark there, a little bit of scale up here, got a scar across the side. It takes up a lot of the space, and it looks really well kind of matched to the shape of the thing. You know, some of the others really look like they're painted on, like they're decals or just added on, but this looks like it's part of it. Really contributes to the entire look and feel of the whole thing, and I love that. And I like the power up too. It's got a transparent red piece on the front, and then a couple different colors of green that, you know, neither one is exactly this, but they go together well with it. And then you've got these two blades or teeth off to the side that are in silver, so you know those are just going to be slicing through things, and you can adjust that. So this way it stands up on its own. Okay, you know, it still will fall over a little bit, but you can adjust these things, you can adjust them down, you can turn around towards the rear and do different things with them. So it allows you to customize and personalize just a little bit without even changing any of the parts. So I'm a huge fan of this Speedorz, and not at all ashamed to say it is my favorite Speedorz to date. Now, the obstacle. This is great too. This looks really good, has an excellent upper crocodile head. Kind of snaggled teeth, nice integration into this terrain area around here with, you know, different colors, kind of earthy tones, and and stone, and you know, just the colors are good on a water base. I guess it's sticking up out of a couple of pools of water, or maybe one pool of water. It just looks good, has a lot of pieces, and they're put together well. It looks like one continuous thing. Some of the obstacles they've made to date, I believe, kind of feel mixed up, like they were made by multiple designers or something, or made kind of cobbled together from different elements. This looks purpose-built. And the reason I keep having to hold this right here is this is the trigger mechanism. So the way that this works in general is that you're supposed to, it's really optimized for two-player play, where you'd have two Speedorz that would get charged up and you race them to the mouth. And whichever one hits this first is gonna knock out this little pedestal. It's gonna knock that right through. It's gonna close the door, basically. It's gonna close the crocodile head down on you or behind you, because you'll go through. And then whoever comes after this is gonna hit this and not be able to get through. So it's really a race to get to the mouth, to hit the trigger, and anybody who comes second just isn't gonna get through. So it should be very obvious who wins. You also have to be accurate enough to get through here, but they do give you a fair amount of width. So it's not so much about accuracy with this one. It's very simple to hit this, very easy to hit it. Let me go ahead and show you how that looks when a Speedorz goes through there. Use Krug. Oops. Well, see, I kind of hit the side, but still managed to knock over the trigger. We'll try that again. Very straightforward, very simple, but it's really a race. If you're going to do this single player, then you'll probably want to put this farther back, like put a lot of distance on it, so it's a little bit harder to hit it, you know, to actually hit the sweet spot in the middle. And then go back and forth, kind of go round robin between your different characters, and wait until one misses and then eliminate that one, you know, and kind of do multiple rounds, maybe best of five, best of seven, something like that, and you know, do multiple rounds to determine the winner. Nice set, has my favorite Speedorz by far, has a very nice looking obstacle to go through. It's good. It's really good. Also, really nice weapon that they include as an extra there. So I'm very happy with this one. Very, very happy. I think this is just well done and makes for something that should make a lot of people enjoy it very much. Even looks good just standing still, honestly. Set number 70112. This is the Croc Chomp from LEGO Legends of Chima. I've got more Speedorz sets that I have already reviewed, so you can check those out on my channel. And I've got more to come, so stay tuned and watch for updates at JANGBRiCKS.com. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.